So hey, hello everyone. So in this video, I'm going to tell you about arrays in Java. So I'm going to start from basic getting input and declaring by yourself. So I'm going to do that stuff here. So let's get started. Currently, I have an empty class and a void function over here. So first, what is an array? An array is a collection of homogeneous data types. That which means that there can be only one type of data type can be used in an array. For example, it can be only numbers, strings, or floats. So it can't have one element being from integer, one element being from float, one element being from string. So that's not possible in an array. So now let me show you how we can declare an array. So just go first. I'm going to declare type of integer. Int is the data type integer. So int arr. This is going to be the name of the array and two square brackets. Okay. So this is the basic format, basic way how you represent an array using square brackets equal to new. Okay. New int, and here we will put 20. So that means 20 elements, okay, that refers to the size or dimension of the array. So this is the basics or a standard way of declaring array. So it's quite similar to in C and C++, even in Python. So okay, whereas in Python you don't have to declare with an what's a data type, but in C and C++ it's nearly the same thing, where you but you don't have new or you do in this in 20, you just give int AR of 20 in C or C++. Okay. So now in Java, this is the way that how you create an array. Suppose you want to give directly the input. Don't want to get the input from the user. You just want to declare all the elements. Okay. It can also be done easily. So just what you need to do that. Just take it and put this curly bracket. Okay. Suppose if I want to give numbers from 1 to 9. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Separate by commas, okay. So this is how you declare, and it will show you an error, okay. Can't define the dimension expression when an array initializes product. So which means that dimension, you shouldn't provide a dimension when you are initializing array elements. So you need to take this off. Now the error goes, okay. So this is how you automatically, or you, sorry, not automatically, you manually assign values instead of getting input from the user. So now what if I want to print an element? Same thing, okay. System dot out dot print printation of. So for first I will put error of 0. This corresponds to the 0th index. I think everyone knows this. This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, it will come one value less in this class as per our thing by elements. So this first element will be considered 0th element, and this 9 will be considered 8th element. So that's how basic we take into account in arrays. Indexing. So now if I run it, I will get the output as 1 because I'm printing it. Just I will run it now. So you can see that the output is 1. Okay. And as I told you, if I print this 8th element, okay, I'll get 9 as the output. Just to show you, 8th element I will print it. I'll get 9 as the output. I'll get both 1 and 9 because I'm putting 0 also. Okay, as you can see, 1 and 9 it shows as 19. So print n, okay. So because I didn't use println, so I will use println. Okay, it basically prints in the next line, new line. So now if I print it, I will get 1, and below that I will get 9. That's good. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to print a number that isn't in the array. So we have index numbers from 0 to 8 in this array. So what if I print index 10? Okay, 10 is basically not present in this array. What will we get if I print something? You should also know that. We want to know the error name also. Sometimes it's quite useful to know it. Sometimes it may come a garbage value, but in this one we get an error. So index 10 out of bounds for length 9. So our length is 9, we are getting an error. So that's how we respond. Okay. So now what's thing we need to do while we are getting input, okay? Input from the user. So I'm going to show you how we'll get an input from the user. 20 is too much. Just I will go with 5. Okay. 5 will do good. So for getting input, basically, you know, scanner is a keyword that is used to get input in Java. So import java dot, it comes in util dot scanner. So that's the keyword used to get input. So for scanner getting inputs here, we are, it's an integer. So for that, what you're going to do is just type scanner, let in be the input. Okay, don't it. I will jump number. Okay, number will be the input. Number equal to new same scanner and system dot in. Okay, number is basically like an NO is basically like an object that is used to get input. So that's what. So next thing is going to be. Next thing we'll just get the input. So first thing what you need to do is we need to get the input by we need to know the size of the array. So that can be done by multiple ways because we know the size, okay? But what if we need to get from that array? We need to extract the size from an array. Just put system. I'm just going to print the size of the array. System dot out dot print println. So it's going to be arr. Arr is the array our array name dot, and as you can see we have this many options is coming. So here is the length. So this length will print the size of the array or the number of elements that's basically size present in the array. So now if I run it, we have here assigned it as five dimensions or size, we will get the output over here as 5. Okay, that's good, we have got the output as 5. This error length is helps in get the size of the array. So now using this we can get the input. So for that what we need to do is just remove it. So as you know thing, we're going to use a for loop. Okay, for int I will be equal to 0 and here I value I less than arr dot length. So this is our end condition because this above 5 it doesn't exist. Okay, and last thing I plus plus. So basic stuff. Okay, how we are going to do in precise, we're just going to use this number which is a scanner object and we are just going to assign this to each array element. So it's going to be arr of I, okay, equal to number, same thing when you're getting input from the as an integer number dot, you're going to use next int. So that's it. This is how you get a number as an input, same thing, we're just going to use it here. So this I value will iterate from 0 to length. Our length is here 5, so 5 less than 5 is 4. So I 0th till 4th index number, this I value will run. So it'll just assign the value. So now if I run this program, we won't get any output because I'm not printing anything here. So it will be just a blank one. So as you can see here, I haven't got anything. So but actually we can type 5 numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and now it just gets generated because I'm just getting input to the 5 numbers. Now what if you want to print this array value, just copy the same thing, paste over here and just make a change over there. Just take edit this and just going to put system, that's basic stuff, system dot out dot println and just you're going to put here the array name. Okay, that's it. This will iterate till 0th and 4th element and every value will get printed. Now if I run this code, so as you can see, I will enter some other numbers. So I'll get 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, as you can see here, I'll go up. Okay, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9 is the number that we have inputted, and 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, that will get the output. Okay, so this is how basic array concept works. And suppose if I did this completely, okay, and if I give just 5 manually, if I give numbers, let me say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, if I want to print this, I'll get the output of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if I want to reverse it also, I can do reverse order, that is from 5 to 1. You can do a minor change over here, just copy this error of length, cut it and paste it here. So starting value will be the last element, okay, and our last value will be I greater than or equal to 0. Okay, so this is going to be last element and it's going to be I minus minus. And AR of length is actually 5, written 5, because we don't have a 5th element over here. So it's going to be AR of length minus 1. Okay, so these are basic conditions to reverse it. So now if I print it, I'll get in reverse order. Okay, as you can see, here 5 first element. So that's, these are the basic stuff necessary to performing arrays, okay, in Java. And check out my other videos. I've done many other videos in Java as well. And thanks for watching.